self-control. So many people are out of control because they don't be led of the Holy Ghost. But we are a Holy Ghost Pentecostal Church of God in Christ. We are no longer holiness. We are Pentecostals. We are Holy Ghost led. And as I say, when the Holy Ghost leads you, he will lead you in the path of righteousness. He don't speak of himself, but the Holy Ghost hears what the Lord, God, the Father, and the Son is saying, and he will transmit it back to you. Come on, if you want to know what the Holy Ghost is saying, you need to, in other words, get in the Word of God and let the Word of God get in you. Come on, say it. Wait on the Lord's promise. He's promised to bring you out. He promised to help you in your decision making. He promised to guide you when you want to know which university, what college to go to, what house to buy, what car to buy, what neighborhood to live in or abide in. He will lead you. He will guide you if you just wait on him. Wait on the Lord and be of good courage. Wait, I say, upon the Lord. Wait on the Lord. They waited. It was 120 that waited in this upper room in Jerusalem. They waited, they waited, and while they waited, they were praising God. When you want the baptism of the Holy Ghost, you got to develop a praise atmosphere. You got to thank him, first of all, for salvation. Thank him for saving you. Thank him for delivering you. Others could have been cut off, but he spared you. So that's enough to thank God that he saved you. He remembered you. How do you know, preacher? Because I know I got a lot of friends from the west side that have gone on and died knowing that they died in their sin, but God spared me because he wanted to give me a gift. He wanted to give me the gift of salvation. This is why it's so imperative, my brothers and sisters, that you witness, that you tell others about the love of Jesus. Listen, you don't really have to be filled with the Holy Ghost to tell somebody that the Lord saved you. But if you want to be more effective in your sharing the gospel, you got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. And let me tell you this, that when you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost, you will speak with other tongues as the Spirit of God gives utterance. You will not speak of yourself. You will not make up your own tongues, as some churches lead people to make up their own tongues. You will not do this. But the Holy Ghost, he speaks for himself. As my father used to say, when you go to store and you buy a pair of shoes, you don't buy the shoes and then send back to the manufacturing company and say, put the tongues in the package and send the tongues so I can put the tongues on my shoes. No, when you buy your shoes, the tongues come automatically. When you receive the Holy Ghost, was anointed to play the harp when Saul was tormented by Satan, tormented by evil spirits. He called for David. David came, took out his harp, started playing music. When he played the music, the anointing was in the music. It caused the evil spirits to behave themselves. Say yes. There's something about the Holy Ghost. It'll make you walk upright. It'll make you treat your neighbor right. It'll make you treat an animal right. It'll make you say yes. I want to say yes. It's like, oh, it's like, oh, something about. He moves within us. Come on, say he's in me. He's in me. When you get saved, you have a measure of the Spirit. When you get saved, you have a portion of the Spirit. But I want you to know there's more. Don't stop at salvation. Don't stop at salvation. Seek for the Holy Ghost. In the book of the 19th chapter, the Bible says that the question was asked by the Apostle Paul to Aquila and Phaselis. He asked him a question: have you received the Holy Ghost since you believe? Have you received the Holy Ghost? Preacher. I sanctified myself in the very God of peace. Sanctify me holy. W-L-H-O-O-Y. He sanctified me holy. He sanctified me thoroughly. When I gave up this world, when I gave up my friends, when I gave up everything that's not like him, I was on the altar in that revival service under the evangelist Cornelius Bird from Detroit, Michigan at that time. He prayed with me, the saints tarried with me, and on that night, the Lord baptized me with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Some of you, you got the Holy Ghost, but you lost your fire. Say to all the seminary.